question number one. I'm just going to read all of them. Number two, at what point was he arrested, charged, or read his rights? Number three, under what circumstances can you act in self-protection? Number five, we skipped four, is the police action considered contributory negligence? And then we go to six. Instruction three, intent, did that begin when he left home or when the car almost hit him? Okay, we got to take these one at a time. If the defendant under menacing intended physical injury, can disorderly conduct be unintentional? Okay, now, my intention is to say that the law of the case is contained in the instructions and your understanding of the instructions, period. Because I don't believe I can give them sort of legal advice. They've got to work past that. Okay, number two, at what point was he arrested, charged, or read his rights? Okay, I'm going to tell them they have to rely on the testimony that they heard, period. There's nothing else to do. I mean, I just don't think. I mean, and it's in a second, I'm going to ask for some input here. Under what circumstances can you act in self-protection? And again, I don't know, the law of the case is contained in the instructions, period. So, you know, part of it is, I think it's their requirement to read the instructions and to understand the instructions. Mm-hmm. And I can't give them legal advice about that. Now, this next one is, I may need some help on because I'm not real confident in this one. It says, is the police action considered contributory negligence? Now, the answer is no, you know, because it's a concept that doesn't apply to criminal law. But I'm not real sure how to answer that. Y'all think about it for a minute. Is the police action considered contributory negligence? Okay, let's go to this other one. Six, which is actually five. Instruction three, intent. Did that begin when he left home or when the car almost hit him? I'm not sure I can answer that question in any way either, other than to say, you know, that they're required to base their decision on the evidence, the testimony that they hear and the exhibits and the law that is contained in the instructions. That's about all I can tell them. Now, I don't know if I need to do anything further on this other one that says, you know, number five, is the police action considered contributory negligence? Do either of you all have a comment about that?
No, I mean, I think what you suggested, Judge, is probably appropriate.
Sure.
I'd agree that, I mean, all the law is contained in those instructions.
And I think if I start getting, you know, it's one of those things, if you start getting tangled up with them, then, you know, they're going to require me to answer, or us to provide an answer for everything that they might have.
So was it five or was it six questions?
It's five, but they're numbered 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6. So they skipped four. They had four, but they crossed it out. And there's some stuff here, and it says, and it's been crossed out. And the best it says is defendant, and then there's something that's just, I have no idea. It looks like going to, maybe, but it was tried to obliterate it. Okay. All right. Okay. Let me try this. Okay, here's my proposal. All right, my proposal is to say your responsibility is to decide the case based on the evidence you heard and the exhibits, applying the law contained in the instructions, period.
It's okay with me, Judge.
Sure. Mr. Price?
Is that in reference to 5-2?
Every one of them.
Okay.
Every one of them. Because I don't, the only one that, because the questions that they have, you know, really, you know, I would hope that they'd be a little further along with this, but there may be, you know, an indication that there are a number of jurors working in different directions here. But the only one that I would consider a different kind of a response to is the police action considered contributory negligence? But even so, you know, it's any kind of specific answer, I'm afraid, would encourage them for more legal advice.
Judge, if I may, perhaps if we could say something along the lines of the entire law applicable to this matter is contained, you know, entire as in there's nothing really outside those instructions for them to apply.
Well, but it's sort of, that's kind of, that's as we start, sort of applying the law contained in the instructions, period. I'm not sure that adds anything there, Mr. Shore, but I'm not, I mean. And Mr. Price, you have any comment about that?
No, I can you tell me what the first question was again, Judge?
The first question is, okay, if, the question is exactly this. If the defendant, comma, under menacing, parent two, close parent, comma, intended physical injury, comma, can disorderly conduct, parent A, close parent, be unintentional? I think I'm going to say exhibits introduced. Now let's talk about the part with regard to the law contained in the instructions. And I think that might be a way to answer number 5. But it may be. Your responsibility is to decide the case based on the evidence you heard and exhibits introduced. And Mr. Shore, what was your statement?
Based entirely. I would just add the word entirely.
Based entirely on the law contained in the instructions. Mr. Price, you know, is that? And I think, I like that for the purpose of addressing this contributory negligence, because I'm not real sure what they're driving at, but I'd like to have sort of an answer to that so that they don't.
But I don't want entirely to, you know, suggest that.
How about applying only the law contained in the instructions, right? Your responsibility is to decide the case based on the evidence you heard and exhibits introduced, applying only the law contained in the instructions. I like that. Is that okay with you, Mr. Shore? And you, Mr. Price?
Yes, sir.
And that kind of covers number 5 there. And Mr. Price, do you have access to a copy machine real fast?
I do.
Why don't we just for the heck of it, because I'm going to give this back to the jury, and I'd like to get it to them right away. And why don't you make a couple of copies, make 3, one for me, you, and Mr. Shore, and I'll put one in the file because oftentimes I'm going to give it to them, and I'd like to have one for the record. Outstanding. What's your name again?
David.
David. David?
Spalding.
Spalding, all right. It'll take me 2 or 3 more years, Mr. Spalding. All right. By that time, you might actually be a lawyer. Everything be, all right.
They don't discourage me from doing so before then.
All right, move along. Anyway. Yep, we may be in for a long night. But it doesn't look like they're that close. Or they got a lot of work to do. All right, Mr. Spalding, thank you much. So I guess y'all can break it up and I'll let you know when we get further work.
All right, thank you.
Tell Mr. Price, how about this? I did not put only in here. Applying only. Here I am trying to do this. I'll tell you what. Okay.